Each region of the brain consists of a highly sophisticated neurological network of cells, dendrites, and nerves, which interconnect one portion of the brain to another. The brain changes physiologically as a result of experience. New dendrites are formed every day, hooking new information to old experiences. As the child experiences an event for the first time, water scooped and poured down a tube, for instance, new dendrites have to be formed. As other information is gained, the water from the tube continues to travel downhill when it leaves the tube, the brain looks to associate the information to existing dendrites. In the future, a child will discover that water always flows downhill because of gravity, and the speed that the water travels depends on the amount of force working on it. The experience of play changes the connections of the neurons at the front end of your brain. And without play experiences, those neurons aren't changed, according to Sergio Pellis at the University of Lethbridge, Canada. Why is it important to change the connections at the front of the brain? Well, it is here in the prefrontal cortex where critical thinking, self-regulation, empathy, creativity, problem-solving, and higher-order thinking skills can take place. We used to believe play was practice for adulthood, but experts have come to believe play has another important role. The function of play is to build pro-social brains, brains that know how to interact with others in positive ways, according to Jack Panskep at Washington State University. Here we observe children sharing time, space, and materials, working independently and interdependently with the clay. This beautifully coordinated interaction is building the framework for future collaboration with others.